Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the third video of the series where I show you how to connect or how to use file backups, use the backup mechanism with Google Drive, and this one is how to connect Google Drive with Tiddly Drive. So now let's enter Tiddly Drive again, and as you can see there we have the synced wiki. And if I double click here, you can see it opens in text mode. That's not what we want. We want to have a Tiddly Wiki, and that's why we can use Tiddly Drive extension. Let's find it, Tiddly Drive. I found it. Okay, so there is some information about Tiddly Drive, and so you can read it. And this extension can be connected to the HTML file by right clicking the file and say open with and connect more apps. Connect more apps, and it searches the store again. There we say Tiddly Drive, and yeah, here it is. Now I open it, very similar, so you can see a little bit of information, and then I can say install. Okay, it needs the permission to connect to the Google account. And then it says, okay, Tiddly Drive was connected to Google Drive. And the last time I did it, I had to log in, so the login procedure may be a little bit different here, but yeah, that's okay, it's installed and connected. Say okay, close it. Now double click, then it opens it, and it tries to load the wiki file. And as you can see, it is loaded, and there is still a draft open. The new Tiddler 2. Let's have a look from the hard disk. So there is the drive wikis and empty. Now I'm loading it here, and this, as you can see, that's the state where we left it. Okay, and there is also one important thing now. We have two versions open at the same time. And here now it will be the last one which saves will win. So let's have a look here. Saving. On the local version, I want to have autosave on. So whenever I click, the Tiddler is automatically saved and immediately saved. And as you can see, then it starts syncing. And after a while, it is there. And if I reload the net version now, reload, the net version has been overwritten. And this is really important. So whoever saves is the last one will win. Then there is a setting here on the right side and right bottom, which is the Tiddly Drive setting, and it can say enable autosave or disable autosave. In this case, I disable it. So if the web version is active, then it's not automatically saved. So if I create a new Tiddler, it doesn't automatically save. It only saves if I say Ctrl S, which I do. Then it starts saving. Needs a little bit of time. And it saved. Now I have to wait a little bit until the syncing is done. Should be done already, okay. And now I see there is the new Tiddler 2. And this is important. So you have two different settings for enable autosave. One which is active when Tiddly Drive is active, and the other one which is active on the page. There could be a problem if you say save in the web, that the server will be confused, and maybe there will be a denial of service or something like this. So this is important. What else is there? Yeah, I think that's Okay, there is the configuration. Control S will work. Yeah, okay, that's basically it. Yeah, this is the information how you can connect Google Drive with Tilly Drive. And the whole series was starting from file backups and the local configuration, how to configure the backup, and now how to activate the drive. Yeah, that's basically it. Have fun.